Until now, we have learned some basic principles of Raman effect. Today, we'll build a simple optical instrument for Raman spectroscopy, at least on paper.
To see Raman effect, we need only four main components: a laser, an optical filter, a spectrograph, and a CCD detector, the same type of detector that you will find in a smartphone's camera. Remember, the Raman effect is the energy change of the scattered photons. Inherently, this is a weak process and only 1 in 100 million photons will be Raman scattered. Luckily, with modern lasers, we can shoot the sample with as many photons as we need, and all these photons can have the same amount of energy, in another word, the same wavelength. The next key part is the optical filter. This filter only allows Raman scattered light to pass through, and reflects Rayleigh scattered light, whose wavelength has not been changed. Now, only the Raman scattered photons are left, but to interpret them, we still need to know their exact wavelengths. The third component here is the spectrograph. Just like a prism, it guides the photon to different directions according to their wavelength. Finally, the Raman scattered photons fall on distinct positions on CCD detector, and thus we capture a photo of the Raman scattered light. This is how an optical instrument excites and detects Raman effect. Next time, we will convert this photograph into a Raman spectrometer.